Hello, financial fans. It is Tuesday. It's the 14th of December of 2021, and the market is down. The S&P 500 is down. The Dow index is down, and NASDAQ is down, and my portfolio is down. So I've decided to buy some stock. I'm increasing my positions in two different stocks, Intel, INTC, and in, what was the other one? VALE, V-A-L-E. I increased my positions in those two stocks today. And I bought V-A-L-E at $13.63.5, and I bought Intel at $49.43.25. So we'll see if that is a wise move. I was thinking earlier today about some things I didn't buy long ago, about 10 or 12 years ago. There were houses for sale in the area here in Tennessee where I live. And the houses, some very nice looking homes with nice properties and so on, were under $50,000, and the really gorgeous houses were under $100,000, and now the really gorgeous houses would be over $400,000, and the houses that were under $50,000 would be about $250,000 probably right now. My point being that I did not buy then. Real estate was low, and that would have been the time that I should have bought. Now, would I be making the same mistake today if I did not buy low-priced stocks? Stocks that are low, buy low, sell high. So I'm going to invest some more in some of the stocks that are down, that look very sad today. But what happens 5 years, 2 years, 10 years in the future? I think this is bargain day on Wall Street, and tomorrow might be another bargain day, and the next day might be another bargain day. And in 2022, the thing that's going to be happening is various politicians suddenly going to step up to the microphone and tell how they're going to change everything. And for politicians, almost always, it's the economy stupid is the way they phrase it. They're going to try to do something to make things better economically. They'll probably mess things up along the way, but the conversation will be drifting in that direction. There also will be talks of the COVID situation and world hotspots where there could be wars breaking out and all that. But I think there is more in the future. Say within the next 6 months, whatever, there will be more things happening that probably will be favorable for the market, at least for the stocks that I own. We shall see if I am right. Someone wanted to know about my Tesla holdings, if I have 100 shares of Tesla. I like to buy 100 shares when I buy stock, and I do own Tesla stock. And the 100 shares of Tesla would be well beyond my reach. The number of shares of Tesla I have, I think it's two shares. Is that correct? Let me take a quick look here. My account, go to positions and slide down and go to Tesla, and we see, oops, okay, two shares of Tesla. There are some stocks where I own 100 shares. There's one where I own 50 shares. There's one where I own one share. There's 50, 20, 20. I have different quantities of stocks. I have one stock that I own 1,000 shares of, but it's not Tesla. That would be nice, wouldn't it, if that happened to land in my account. But I think right now we do have a buying opportunity going on, and it's an odd type of buying opportunity when the market is near its all-time top, and yet it's falling. How can that be? Falling up the escalator stairs or something. But today I did buy VALE and I bought INTC. And I am waiting for the market to turn around and see some of these stocks that I've purchased recently go up in value. And until then, I will sit by and watch. And I thank you very much for watching.